A very good morning, good afternoon, good evening from wherever you're watching us from, and say karibu sana to another edition of Urban Kale. This is definitely Urban Kale TV, and I'm your host Zion San. And you know, when we talk about Urban Kale, we are talking about interrogating culture. We get to talk also about current affairs and so many issues affecting the society. And today I'm super excited, Manze, that we are hosting one of the leaders of this county of Kericho. Remember, we are coming to you live from the CBD, from the heart of the green city itself, Kericho County. And of course, we are also coming to you ndani ya Kipchimat restaurant. Ukiangalia maneno hapa kidogo, our set is looking awesome. Courtesy of Kipchimat supermarket. Kipchimat have a lot of products, but before we get into that, I'd like to invite my guest officially on the show. Karibu sana mheshimiwa Eric Bett. Niate.
Poa bro.
Uko salama?
Niko salama.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you, thank
you. It's good to have you.
Thank you so much.
It's been a while.
I appreciate you hosting me today.
Karibu sana.
Thank you.
And so you're looking nice.
Thank you, Bana.
Unakaa fit.
Thank you. It's the grace of God, actually.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Mimi pia nilipitia pale Top Glam Collections.
Alright.
There's a lady called Salome.
Alright.
Akanipiga hii look mzuri. That is why nimeng'ara kabisa.
You're looking awesome.
Alright, sawa. So mheshimiwa, you are the member of county assembly for Kipchabor ward,
yes,
in Kericho County. But before we get into your career as a politician, tuambie bana, umekuwa wapi ama ulitokea wapi? Where did you come from? Tell us about your family, mali, you know, mali, where you grew up.
Thank you so much, Zion. Well, me, I'm just a local guy. I was born in this town. Some time to come to Aida.
All right.
Well, just come from the village. Village called Kimungan Village, and I grew up there. Mm-hmm. Went to local primary school called Captain Beswet Primary School.
Captain Beswet.
Then I went to Kericho High School thereafter.
Ah, okay.
And then I hustled kidogo for about 3 years at home.
Mm-hmm.
And then got a kafungwa njia. I went to the university in Nairobi, called USIU.
Ah.
On scholarship, by the way.
USIU, all right.
Yes. So I didn't go on. Nienda na scholarship.
Na dynasty.
Singeweza kulipa hiyo fee bana mzee.
Okay.
So soma kwa akafungua njia.
All right.
Some partial scholarship ya kwa USIU.
Mhm.
It bachelor of commerce in finance.
Mhm.
And then I graduated in 2010.
Mhm.
Thereafter I went to nipata kazi kidogo Chase Bank.
Aha. All right.
Tanzania kidogo.
All right.
Then from thereafter I went to G4S Company Limited.
Okay.
Where now I was able to get a very nice entry level into the corporate world.
Ah,
and
okay.
That's where I got the name Watchman there.
Watchman, because you're working in a security
yes,
company.
Yes, so I'm there for some time, for about close to 6 years.
Okay.
And then in 2017, Mungozi.
To piga ikitu.
So I got the brand Watchman from the work I used to do at G4S. When I started going to G4S, I was given assignment to be a guard, actually.
Oh, really?
Yes. Okay. It was part of the training.
Okay.
That if for you to be a manager, lazima kwanza kuwe mlinzi.
Must
be a guard. So somehow I became a watchman.
So ulipa uniform?
Yes, I did for about 3 months.
Okay.
Part of the training in G4S was that for you to be manager, to be a general manager, you must be able to know what guard goes through.
Ah, okay. So let me ask you. Ulikuwa mnatumia zile room?
Of course. Uniform, branded, tie, G4S, kila kitu. I worked at I worked in Bett in Nairobi, Coca-Cola.
Okay.
And even in Prime Bank also as a guard there. It's part of the training.
Oh really?
Yes, as a guard. So I used to open gates, record vehicles coming in and out as part of the training.
Oh.
And I will tell you that was the most, I would say, my education. This is very humbling to do something.
Mm-hmm.
And when you are educated and you can be able to go to that level, it reminds you that apart from the education you have,
yes,
you can also become, you can serve the people in any capacity. In the lowest capacity of a God.
Wow.
So that's about me in summary and about
your life, kiddo.
About life, kiddo, in terms of politics.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, you've also asked me about the issue of maybe like family.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to say I'm also proud because my family supported me all through.
Yes.
I have a family, I have two boys. I have
That's like your own family,
my son. Family, no.
Shikili hapo kidogo. Turudi nyuma.
Yes.
Your family, mali ulizaliwa.
Yes.
You know, your parents and your siblings. Mulizaliwa mkiwa wangapi? How many were you in your family?
Well,
I know in Kale we don't, you know, we don't take
the number of children.
Yeah.
Yes, we're a large family, by the way. Mm-hmm. So we have 10 children in our family.
Wow.
So the family of 10, I'm the 9th born.
Oh, okay.
The 9th born. Yeah, I'm the 9th born in a family of 10.
Alright.
And I forgot because in the entire family, okay, I lost my dad when I was in primary school.
Holy,
so raised by my own mom. Oh. 10 children, my mom. From the time I was in class 5 up to date. So my mom has struggled with all the 10 children. And,
how did you go through schooling? I mean, I'm just imagining, you know, being the struggle of being raised by a single mother,
yes,
10
yes.
kids. But to have a struggle to go. Up on the Nataka, tell us about
it. It was a real struggle. The only thing, it was a real struggle because it was a real struggle in terms of going to school. Even when I was in graduate high school, you know, there were fees arrears. And somehow my mom was a hard worker and managed to pull through.
Mm-hmm.
But when I finished high school, I studied for 3 years, good years at home.
Because
I couldn't go to the university because my siblings, my elder brothers and sisters were in college.
Wow.
So I had to lay back for about 3 years. That is why the scholarship came in handy.
Oh.
When I applied 2 years, I got partial scholarship.
Wow. Yeah. So what were you doing? We are in a restaurant and definitely, you know, we have to take care of our people, feed the people. This is Kipchimat restaurant, so kazi natambika pale kitchen vizuri sana. And remember, by the way, you can make your way to Kipchimat restaurant for amazing sumptuous meal. Lakini mweshimi wa kidogo.
Yes.
So what were you doing during the 3 years of your... of that break, that
yes,
transition
yes.
period.
Okay, like hustling. Okay, I spent most of the time in the church.
Right.
I was a youth leader. I put my time to work in the church.
Oh.
I used to do evangelism in the church.
Mm-hmm.
Used to do programs, community programs, like maybe like environmental conservation.
Mm.
So basically, I was in government community events.
Oh.
And remember, you see, I got that scholarship to the university to the USIU because while I was doing this. Events in the church.
In the church.
I got a link to a friend, to somebody who used to work at the university, and said, "Why don't you apply? We can offer you some support."
Oh,
so
okay.
You see, I want to encourage young people that when you are out there, you don't have hope.
Mm-hmm. Do something. Mm-hmm.
Do something. You never know.
Volunteer.
You volunteer somewhere. If you come to Kanisa Mahali, come on anything. Just volunteer.
Mm-hmm.
You never know. Like you see, my story is that when I was living in the church, I didn't know that I was going to get a link to the university, get a partial scholarship, which would then thereafter, you know, the Kadipati, you know, chance to come. Because those 3 years was the minimum I was at home.
Wow.
But remember, those 3 years was, I mean, I could even spend more time.
Yes.
I could even, I'm not going to the university in the first place.
Yeah.
Because the issue of the fees.
Mm-hmm. But you see, you stepping out, like
yes.
when the public church
yes.
and just doing stuff.
Exactly. And I know there are many young people maybe out there who are always asking themselves, you know, maybe don't
yeah.
have support.
Mm-hmm.
I also struggle.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, somehow, through my passion to serve in any capacity, God has opened my eyes.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Heart of service.
Heart of
You've
service.
Been serving kabisa from.
Exactly. Na fungua mlango yote. None.
Hey. Tukunye maji. Kunye maji, mheshimiwa.
Thank you, bro. Thank you.
Unasikiaje maji?
This water is.
Unasikia ina quench thirst kabisa.
Of course, and this maji.
This is Mbogo mineral water.
Yeah, awesome water. I'll recommend this water to anybody.
Kabisa. When you make your way to Kipchimat supermarket or any other supermarket out there, definitely, you know, make an effort. You know, kunywa maji yako ya Mbogo mineral water, and trust you, me manzi, you're gonna be. Unasikia tu mwili yako thirst yako ina katika instantly, courtesy of. Bogo mineral water. Alright, so umemaliza, you've transitioned, ukaenda USIU.
Yes.
You know USIU, we get to see it, sisi huku inje tunajua kama ile, you know, university ya mababi, nini, wase wako na pesa. You know, how was your experience? Did you experience like culture shock? Ama mpotu sawa? You know, I mean, you coming from the village and interacting with international students, how was that experience?
Yeah, it was shocking, by the way, because, you know, like you see from my background, I was just in local school, yeah, to best with them, Kerucho High School. So going to university again, then going to international university.
Wow.
Because the university is not like going to a university. So, the culture shock was there, of course, and we managed to adapt through. Mm-hmm. And I thank God because it gave me a chance to understand that the life was not just in Kericho here. Mm-hmm. It's just about going home and visiting China, going to Uganda. Yeah. It's more than that.
There's no life outside.
Exactly. And I think also it was a good, so it became a very nice experience to me. Mm-hmm. So really, get to interact with people from all walks of life. Mm-hmm. And I also challenged myself and said, though I come from the village, mm-hmm. I also need to also become a leader. Mm-hmm. And so, my strong leadership also was developed there. Mm-hmm. So while at the university, mm-hmm. I joined some clubs. I joined some organizations there, all sides, business club. Uh-huh. And then I also vibe.
Oh,
so
okay.
So by the time I was in my second year, mm-hmm. I was the club chair for business club of the USIU.
Oh.
And in that year, mm-hmm. I ran for the leadership of the university.
Oh.
And I was the organizing secretary for the student council.
Okay.
Yeah, so nikujiamini tu bro. Nijiamini.
Wakelea uzito.
Yeah, thank you. So,
wow, you've been, yani ulianza kitambo. Leadership and service.
I've always asked myself, why can't I?
Why not? What so is the worst thing that can happen?
Yeah. The worst thing that can happen is that it's loose.
Yeah, all right.
That's the worst that can happen. But if you try something, the most you can get is you don't get it.
Mm.
And life continues.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Amazing. So, 2017, you know, I saw you campaigning. Umeva ile bere ya ma Watchman. Na hiyo uniform ako ka sweater that pullover and nini na boots. And I actually thought you were like an actual watch ule kabisa ametoka tu job ya kuchunga. How was that experience? Did you feel like you connected with the people and that is why the people elected you to be the member of county assembly?
My friend Zion.
Yes.
I will tell you, that was the most humbling and the most memorable thing in my life.
Alright.
Because mm-hmm. when I was doing that, I felt it. Really feel kabisa. Yani, I was only feeling, you know, when I was in that uniform,
mm-hmm.
there's no single day I regretted wearing that uniform.
Alright.
So I could feel the connection with the people.
Mm-hmm.
I could feel the local people telling me, go for it.
Alright.
And it was so good because I think if there was a decision that I took, that was the best decision at that time.
Mm-hmm.
Was to humble myself
mm-hmm.
and to buy the uniform. And I could see the connection. When I was walking in this town,
mm-hmm.
on foot, wearing that uniform.
Mm-hmm.
I could feel there was something special about that particular attire that I had.
Alright.
And so the condition was that I knew back then that even if I'm going to the MCA,
mm-hmm.
but there's something I've left a mark in the people's
house.
You want to do it to come, other than what I get,
when
a connection mahali, there's something deep. And something deep, something.
Wow.
Yeah? And so when I was going through the campaign mood, I realized that I was getting favor from God. I was feeling, I was getting deep with people.
Mm.
So that was a very good experience for me.
This is Kenya. Yes, when you watch man, when you know, you just, you know, unaka, you're connecting with people. Wase walikuchangia pesa ya ku campaign ama walikuwa wanakutisha pesa hapa na kwambia watch man toka kitu.
Of course, on the contrary, people changed for me, by the way.
Oh, really?
Yes, of course, there are a few who wanted money.
Mm-hmm.
But I would say, from the when I was doing my campaign,
mm-hmm.
most people kind of always supported me.
All right.
I remember walking this town and people could even offer me to say, okay, Yamaji. Yeah, kama ya mbogo ba,
kama ya mbogo, mbogo, mineral water.
Because I used to walk, you know, on foot, all that kind of stuff. So people could offer me anything.
You didn't have a pikipiki?
No, nothing. They didn't have even just a microphone. They didn't have. There's nothing. There's no view. There's no speaker. The only thing I afforded was all the posters.
Wow.
In terms of mobility, to be on a speaker, man,
mm-hmm.
I didn't want the price of to hire even a generator or even a speaker. Because I could budget younger.
Oh my goodness. Yeah, look at you now.
Yeah, look at me.
Look at you now, Manzi. Wow.
Yeah.
This is such an amazing story. Eh?
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm just imagining also campaigns in a pigwa, ama, you know, now to Babu. You know, the returning officer is about to make the announcement.
Yeah.
How was that experience as well? You up to unangoja, unangalia numbers and everything. How was it?
It was a tense moment, of course, like anybody when you're waiting for results.
Mm-hmm.
But I'd given my all.
Did you know you were going to win?
Somehow I had a hunch that I was going to win. Somehow there was that voice telling me,
Ikitu Nabeba.
Alright. But I was prepared for the worst. Okay. I was prepared for losing actually. And I think that is the best thing, you know, the best thing you can ever have is that when you're running for anything, prepare for the worst to lose. So that it happens that way. You manage that situation.
Right? Yeah, you can manage.
So for me I was prepared to lose, but I knew Ikitu. Gonna favor because I could walk, you know, you could listen, you could hear that gonna something, yeah? You could feel.
Alright.
You could even go and people, you know, even something tells you, you know, you're getting this thing and I could feel it. So it was so real.
Mm-hmm. So on that note, you know, I have to let my viewers also get to know about a few things, courtesy of Kipchimot Supermarket. They have amazing product. You know, we are coming from Kericho, manze. Na Kericho, unajua, this is the land of tea. And as you can see, we have Mbogo tea. Si Mbogo mineral water peke yake. We have Mbogo tea. We also have Mbogo Valley. This comes in different packaging and different taste beer. We also have Kuresoi. Sana sana, my mom loves this. Kila time when I'm visiting my mom is always saying, tafadhali. Nilete, we remember to come with Kureso. So you come a family yako muna kunyo
na kani? Yeah,
kunyo Kureso, yeah?
And Bogo, both of them.
Ah, nice. Alright. Mm. Yes, and then of course we have this golden blend as well, courtesy of Kureso. So please, I mean, whenever you make your way to Kipchimot Supermarket, remember to shop. Alafu pia, unajikamatia special packaged rice courtesy of Kipchimot Supermarket. Very affordable prices, by the way. If you make your way huku, utashanga sana manze with the kind of pricing vile kuko. It's really very favorable to your pockets. I'll see you. Alright. So Mheshimiwa, you've been announced. You are the winner. Mtu amesimama, the returning officer, ama presiding officer, amesimama akasema. And the winner for Kipcheboru Award is Honorable Eric Bett. Tell us about that moment.
Well, it was so good. Mm-hmm. It was in Richard Day Secondary School here.
Mm-hmm.
It was so humbling.
Mm-hmm.
It was a defining moment.
You feel chills run from you.
Yes, I felt chills. I was still wearing the uniform. I think it was. Wow. I didn't even know it. You know, it was waiting for the whole night.
Mm-hmm.
It was so cold, but I could feel, I was just feeling I was okay, but somehow I was being told you need to get a sweat or something.
Yeah.
Because I didn't even know that was.
What of a guru, me, I think, what of a guru,
and then, I didn't even get time going to relax because even after the people had enough to do, I want people
celebration.
Yeah, the whole night, and I didn't sleep.
Oh.
But I had to, somehow I had to gather some courage and just try to, you know, wave back to people because I was so tired.
Uh-huh.
But then again, I've been announced the winner. People want to see me.
Now people want to kutembeza
in town. People want to hug me. Mm-hmm. I didn't have the energy, but I had to kazana.
Juju.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what winning is about. You know, that moment, you got a culmination of self-belief. And determination and just putting your best foot forward,
yes,
and believing that God is going to, you know, help you through whatever you went through.
Yes.
Sasa, fast forward, this is 2021, Mheshimiwa. Umekua, and of course, kazi yako imeonekana, we've seen the roads, zile umefanya. The other day, I was driving with my pastor to kielekea huko karibu na Kikutu mahali.
Oh, yes.
And I was amazed at the way, you know, mabarabara huko katikati ya chai imetengenezwa vizuri. I know also you've been doing boreholes in Nyagacho and a couple of other places. You've been working. I think you've been featured as one of the most hardworking young MCAs in this county of ours.
Thank you.
But Nikona Swan, 2020, I mean from 2018, Maboya BBI come and all that. Kidogo, you know, Kericho County Assembly, ama Kericho County was perceived as anti-BBI. Nim, alafu kidogo mukarushiwa car grants. Kwanza umepata car grants?
Of course, hii ilikuja.
Ilisha come. Kwa hivyo naweza angukia ka ride tukimaliza show.
Of course, lazima.
Alright. Nini, car grants ilikamu mukapitisha BBI, and yet, you know, kwa watu kwa ground ni kama kidogo they were against it. Kulienda aje mheshimiwa?
Yes,
you betray the people.
Well, no.
Ama kuna mazuri gani kwa hii BBI yenye
watu? In Detroit, no. Like for me, I was very categorical. During the time BBI came on board, I engaged the people I represent. And I was able to explain what was in that document. And the BBI had issues to do with that, the good stuff and the bad stuff. Basically, the bad stuff to me was the huge wage bill that is going to come with implementing this BBI. And so my conscience was to vote for no, which I voted for no in the assembly. And it's on record that I did not support the BBI.
Oh, okay.
But remember, and the assembly is a game of numbers.
Yes.
It is the numbers that count in terms of voting.
Yeah.
So we were, the dissenting voices of voting against the bill were few in the assembly.
Okay.
So after discussing the document, giving my reason for not supporting it and voting, of course the Kericho County voted for yes.
The majority had their way.
Had their way and I had my say.
And you had your
say. The majority like that.
So, all right.
Yeah, so that's an issue that personally I did not hide under the sun. I spoke my mind and I said this document has some good stuff and
yes.
bad stuff. And the bad stuff was the huge wage bill, which I thought I'd say it will not help this country moving forward.
Yeah. I mean, talking about wage bill and talking about the debts that we are
in right now.
And we are in the middle of a pandemic and stuff like that.
Yes.
I thought also this thing wasn't urgent as much. We could postpone it to another. But anyway, that is not up to me. It is up to Kenyans to decide.
Yes.
Juzi pia, we heard about Super Bowls in the you know, kulikuwa vitetezi, for lack of a better word. Tulisikia kwamba, you denied the speaker. The speaker was requesting for a 12 million shillings V8 armored vehicle. Is that true? Ambassador Zimbabwe rumor.
That's just propaganda.
Yes.
And I sit in the budget committee. And there was, of course, truth be told is that it was supposed to be in our plan. It was supposed to be the president of the speaker's vehicle. As by the laws of Kenya and procurement, a vehicle that has stood for more than 5 years needs to be disposed and buy a new one.
Okay.
So the vehicle was there to be replaced. But somebody decided to bring another thing that it was going to be a V8 armored, all kind of stuff. That was pure lies.
Okay, so what was the truth? What was the Garigane Mukom now?
The truth of the matter is that it was going to be a vehicle that was going to fit the vehicle that the speaker is using right now.
Okay.
It's a Prado.
Alright.
But of course, you know, when you're buying a vehicle, you need specification what you want.
Okay.
4x4, 3.0, diesel liter engine. So it can be. It could be a V8, it could be a Lexus, it could be any vehicle, as long as it fits that category of that. But I will tell you that the budget was not following because it was around 10 million shillings, which was in the budget, and the vehicle was floated for tenders to come on board. So the whole idea, I think, it just became political for no reason.
Okay.
And in this case, that is an asset for the assembly. It's not even for the speaker in the first place.
But forgive me, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, sir. May I ask? You know, I know kuna budget, kila department and everything.
Yes.
But ukiangalia, you know, even such 10 million shillings, how many boreholes will that be? Because do we want to share the amount?
Yes, yes.
You know, Moshima, you know very well that we've been having a lot of problems when it comes to water for the past couple of months. And for the residents, some of the people of Kericho County, here, 10 million shillings is going to buy a vehicle for, you know, for members of the county assembly or even the speaker. Kidogo, you wouldn't be surprised, you shouldn't be surprised when now it takes a political angle and people begin to ask questions. Yeah? If we were sorting all these other issues, and I know you'd be doing your best, then perhaps it would be okay to say, let's take care of our
I agree with you, but remember, that's why even in the long run, what happened is that he's so understanding. You know, we removed that money. We told us, let's delay. The fact that in the budget, we removed that amount of money. And we put in other stuff. Because we told the speaker, since the budget is, since we had it in tough economic times,
yes.
Budget 2 is a great amount, and he accepted. So the money was removed, so we have delayed the process according to the idea.
Okay.
Maybe within the next financial year.
Yeah.
In the spirit of just trying to accommodate and trying to be to see what is most urgent.
Yes.
Yeah. So the katoa is.
Okay.
But remember, it is just like the way you put it. Eh?
Yes.
It has every department has its own line item. For example, we cannot deny, like, for example, the SRC has given us, we need to buy, we need to build speakers residence, the governor's residence is there, because we're paying rent for them right now. Also, Britain is cheaper. We pay for the speaker, the governor, deputy governor, rent every single month.
Of course, that is more
running into millions of money. Mm-hmm. So the SRC, the government says, build residence for these guys, let them occupy. When they leave office, they leave the residence. Okay. Somebody else comes and occupies. Okay. So in the long run, it is better to build a residence.
You're going
to
save money.
Yeah, save money. That's the same way, you better get a vehicle that is going to last. Because in the long run, it's required. But in this pandemic right now, I do agree with you that we need to remove some of this unnecessary spending and put it now where we need, where the most is required the most.
Yeah.
I think in this case, I want to thank the speaker because I'm Kubani. Control your present. I'm here to Kubia, but I'm Kubwa. Boy, the next financial year. Now, Kubwa, to control your present, better begin.
All right.
And I think, to be fair, I think he's a good leader because of something.
Okay. Now, what happens to this other vehicle in America for 5 years?
Now what happens now, it can be as bad, you have the laws of disposal act.
Okay.
So it can be disposed, and you have vehicles here that we are being disposed, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
Just like the normal government spending, you need to dispose vehicles. So if you dispose, that money comes back to the county, can be used for any other thing. So it means, therefore, if you dispose, because the vehicle, the longer will be expensive to maintain.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, government, very cancer kuwa ribikaribika, na kuwa scandal pia.
Oh yes.
Na kukula kwa gari imekula 200,000 kila mwezi hivyo.
Correct.
In 1 year, unasikia hiyo gari imetumika kwa garage 1 million shillings.
Which is enough to buy another.
Exactly, yeah. So to avoid that kind of a thing, it's better to get a new vehicle. So that now you just go for service.
Okay.
And that's why in government it's not advisable that you continue keeping a vehicle or an asset that is consuming cost of maintenance, because then it becomes, it will be abused.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Makes sense. So going forward, I know Kericho County is also our deputy governor as well. It's about 2-3 weeks ago, and I don't know what message would you have for the Kericho people. And also, I know we already have a city. The nomination has happened.
No, we are getting the nominee on Tuesday next week.
Yes.
And then thereafter, we'll discuss on approval or disapproval. So,
Alright,
we're not yet discussed about
okay. But what message would you like to give to Kericho people, especially the family of Susan Kikwai?
Well, the family of Susan Kikwai, I think I want to say that we only not lost a brilliant deputy governor.
Mm-hmm.
We also lost a person who was so instrumental in running the government.
Mm-hmm.
If there's one person who was holding this administration so close, so running, it was none other than the late Susan Kikwai. You know, she was an unsung hero.
Yeah, she was.
Yeah, she was somebody like Gwana Cheza, Chinia Maji, Kini Credit Achukui. Naona. I think that was good for us. So we lost somebody who was a pillar in governance of the district. Even the governor himself knows. Because this one person who could sit in the boardroom, make things happen, and do not take credit for anything.
Yeah.
So the family called the son. To the people of Kericho County, COVID-19 is real. Corona is real. It's going to affect everybody. The fact that our DG lost the battle to COVID-19. It means anybody, despite your profile, your age, your agenda, the key to combine.
Mm-hmm.
So we are feeling that we need to take care and follow strictly the government protocols.
Yes.
Otherwise, I will pray that the next nominee will also do justice. Afanye kazi mzuri, afanye kazi ambayo sasa. So we wish the best to the new nominee. Akipata hiyo kiti ya kwa DG,
well,
at the very best, and ask her afanye kazi watu wakilicho.
Kabisa. All right. So we've been. Najua wanasemanga. Once you are a politician, you know, you have to be ambitious.
Yeah.
We have to be ambitious. Lazima. That people, you've been overworking. Naonanga pale status yako. I also natembea in town. You've really been working.
Yeah.
Seen some of the shapes, the new Betangeneza, what the artist is. You are helping out hustlers. Are you running for the same seat come next year, or you are running for, you are aspiring for something higher?
Well, I would have wanted to go for a higher seat, but I want to defend first, because I believe there are things there are things I've not achieved when I was in the seat of the MCA, and I've given a second term, I think I'll deliver that. So I would want to rush quickly up the ladder. I think I want to cement my background first. I want to cement the grassroots first.
Okay.
And I think in a fair skill, I think 2 terms would be enough for me to do that.
Okay.
So I'm hoping that next year I will seek for the election for the same seat of MCA.
Do you believe you can win?
I believe I can win. I believe I have the capacity, I have the experience, and I have the goodwill.
All right.
And the frustration also needed to do that. What I need to do is just look back, assess the situation, and get the money about the concept, I correct it, because I believe I'm 100%.
Yes.
I believe in what I have achieved, it is a good platform for me to say then, I have done this. I seek for my mandate. So I will need to put my house in order, we can go for it.
Okay, so talking about what you have done, Ninini, Dino Mufana, Ama, what have you done, Mishino? I know I've mentioned a few that I've seen, but perhaps I could be overlooking some of your major achievements. What have you been able to achieve so far?
I think to say, in terms of development, I have done quite a number. Road networks, I've done good number of roads.
How many kilometers?
I think more than 10 kilometers of new roads.
Oh, okay.
Maramed. And stuff, and the residents can attest to that. I've also done some other projects, about 3 of them. Even the last few, 2-3 weeks, there was no water in Kericho town. And people called me, Okinambia Sante Moshimba, because that's the organizing manager. So for me, that was good feedback. You know, when people call you to tell you thank you for something you've done, it tells you
you are on the right
track. You didn't do it in vain.
Yes.
You can do something and no one talks about it.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
the water was a big thing.
Uh-huh.
And also it was something small I did, but it became a big thing in terms of the impact. Uh-huh. More than the roads. Then there was also the border sheds, the markets. And most importantly, what I have done is have been keeping close contact with my business. I'm one guy.
That one I have to give it to you.
Yes, and I can tell you it's even more important than even the roads. Because you see, I could be doing the roads, I could be doing the water, but if I'm not keeping close contact with the electorates in terms of being responsive to their needs. Because you see, I've always wanted to be a responsive leader.
Yes.
Where there's an issue, I respond quickly, I act on that. And I've always wanted to be that kind of leader who's responsible, who's reliable in terms of, you know, because leadership is tested when there's a challenge.
Yes.
For example, when there's a problem with Kodakoda runners in town, look for me. How do I solve that issue? If I'm not available, can't solve anything, then what am I for?
Okay.
Yeah, if people are selling in town, come to the hotel, I'd be stressed. And I'm not available, you know? Okay. So for me, I think, some of all these impacts is that I've always made sure that I've always responded to any issue. Okay. Even if I get a strange call today, I'm going to Mwishima. When I've got a mahali to pull up for the last 2-3 weeks,
yes.
This idea.
Yes.
I'm not a guy who just asks. I'm a guy who will go there and act on there.
Alright.
Okay. And I'm going to go to the hotel and I'm going to collect it.
Okay.
That's for me, I think it's a
alright.
It's a selling point to buy. People remember me for that.
I would like us to take a break kidogo, maybe to kunywa kachai, courtesy of Kiptimat restaurant. You know, hatuwezi tuko tumeanika majani hapa na tukose kukunywa chai.
Definitely.
Au sio? So maybe you can take a break kidogo and then we come back, alafu we wrap it up. And of course, you know, to skia watu wanasema aje. Alright. Let's take a break with you.
Thank you.
All right, welcome back to Urban Kale TV. I'm definitely your host, Zion San, and I'm hanging out with Mheshimiwa Eric Bett, member of County Assembly for the ward of, representing the ward of?
Kipchebor
yes. Ward.
Yes.
Mheshimiwa, you are the people's watchman. Umekuwa ukiangalia masuala ya watu. How would you rate yourself?
Well, on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the highest, I'd give myself a 7.
A 7?
Yes.
So, unafikiri maybe between now and next year, utakuwa umejaza hiyo tatu? Ama mbili, ama utakuwa umeongeza moja?
Yes, I will.
Utakuwa umeshukisha?
No. Definitely. I'm targeting at least an 8.
Yeah.
If I get 80%, I think it would be fair because it is also an unrealistic to say you've done 100% with the challenges and, of course, being the first time and stuff like that. So,
okay.
I think 70% is fair.
Sawa. So, mimi, when you took a break, nikaenda nikaorganize mambo ya chai. Mwajua tumeanika majani hapa. Kuna mbogo vali hapa. Kuna mbogo tea premium. Kuna kuresoi na kuna golden blend. And of course, manze, when you make your way to Kipchimat supermarket, unapata a very affordable rice, very, kuna ini ile unapika kidogo hivi, inajaa kwa sufuria na inanukia vizuri sana. So, nilipanga mambo ya chai, na nataka letwe. Apapia watu wangu, tafadhali leta chai mkubwa. Yes, unaweza toa hii, weka kwa kando kidogo. Nikunywe hii maji kabla urudishe. Asante sana. Thank you. Mheshimiwa, feel free to weka chai kidogo. So ulikuwa unaniambia next year, by next year utakuwa umefikisha ngapi mheshimiwa? Umefikisha nane?
Yeah, nane bana, 80%.
Yeah.
At least hapo.
And you believe you stand a chance?
I believe so.
You know, I was also thinking of running against you.
Yes.
To be your challenger. So, unajua pia mimi naweza.
Really?
You know I can.
Yes.
But nikasema, wacha bado wakati wangu, utafika. Okay, so, Santi, Oscari hapa. Mbonja hiyo chai alafu niambie wacha niongeze sukari kidogo. Iko sawa kabisa.
Fantastic.
Unasikia hiyo chai?
Damu mbaya.
Iko sawa. Unasikia thickness?
Thickness very nice.
Na harufu yenyewe ya kuresoiti.
Very nice.
Iko salama. So grab yourself. Ukitaka kuonja chai mzuri manze, just come and grab one of these amazing products courtesy of Kipchimat supermarket na mambo itakuwa safi zaidi. By the way mheshimiwa, unaona jinsi yangu? Nimeona yako iko sawa.
Yes, yako pia iko sawa.
Yangu iko sawa. Yangu ni iPhone.
iPhone, eh?
Yangu ni ni Apple.
All right.
Yako ni gani?
Yangu tu ni analog tu ya kawaida.
Like sawa. Hii nimejishikia in one of the nini inaitwa. We have, you know, I have to mention this because we have a young entrepreneurs. Kuna vijana wawili ambao wanafanya kazi nzuri sana. They have opened a shop ya kuuza bags, ladies bags, watches, really good watches inaitwa U plus me. Kienda pale utapata services za M-Pesa.
All right.
And you know where it is? It is iko ndani ya Green Square Mall.
All right.
First floor.
Oh.
Inje tu ya Kipchimat supermarket first floor, utapata one U plus me.
U plus me.
Utapata all your watches and bags and stuff like that.
Oh, awesome.
I'll see you. All right. So, Mheshimiwa, going forward, national, let's look at now what is happening nationally. Bado kuna mambo ya referendums at BBI. We've now had kina Oparanya saying, we don't need to do a referendum right now. Maybe we can wait and combine it with next year. Kia, the DP himself, akisema, you know, do we really have to do it now? You know, what, I mean, ebu weka perspective yako in that conversation.
Well, the issue of the BBI actually is a good conversation. You know, once the assemblies passed the BBI, the next thing was not a referendum. But look at the country where it is now. So in my own perspective, I believe
this discussion of BBI referendum should stop fast. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's an urgent problem what we have now, mm-hmm. the pandemic, the mm-hmm. corona. Mm-hmm. You know, and we cannot hide ourselves under the sun. Mm-hmm. So, in all fairness, mm-hmm. this thing may be important, but not more than the pandemic.
Yes.
So, if they, all efforts should be focused on the corona pandemic.
Yes.
So, kama lazima ifanyike, it can be done together with next year's elections, or even thereafter.
Yeah.
Upon urgency.
All right.
The thing is, they've gotten the threshold of more than 24 county assemblies.
Yeah.
So upon agency, the agency matter now is on the corona pandemic. Mm-hmm. So your person got to meet for referendum, mm-hmm. it can be used to channel to fight this pandemic.
Yes.
So maybe my proposal is that mm-hmm. let it happen when things are at control in terms yes. of the corona pandemic.
Yes.
Yeah. So aina issue.
Na tumelipa lipa China kidogo tumefikisha deni mahali.
Exactly. It's a good priority right now. It's a good priority right now. I mean, you're saying now, how do you even discuss something like that? Na kuna issue ambayo inakuumiza hapo.
And even, you know, the campaigning itself is going to expose more people.
Exactly.
We don't want to see people dying of it because the new strain right now, the variant, it's more infectious, and we've seen people dying, even prominent people.
Exactly.
You know, yeah. Like in the words of Pierre Lumumba, he said Kenya is not being wound up. Kenya, so some of the things can wait. But like I said, you know, me up to the people to decide.
Mm. All right.
So to wrap it up, Mheshimiwa, your parting shot to the people of Kipchemor Ward, and even to all of the people that are watching us right now all over the country.
All right. My parting shot is very simple, that somebody like me was elected into office to help people.
Yes.
Mimi ni mwakilishi wa watu. Nisema ukweli ni kwamba, I cannot solve all the problems of all the people I represent.
Yes.
So my plea is that every person doing hustle yake, do hustle in the right way, and just know that if you do it with all the heart, we pende hiyo kazi yako. Mm-hmm. Then serikali inaweza kusaidia ufike mahali. So my plea is that every young person there, every mama, every person out there is doing his hustle. Do it with all your heart and do it well, mm-hmm. because it will take you far. So, but as a leader, I always try to make sure that kama kuna anything I can do as a leader, mm-hmm. I respond to that issue. Kama mtu wa boda anahitaji mimi nitengenezee boda boda shit, I will do it. As long as yeah, fanya kazi yako kwa njia ambayo inafaa.
All right.
So to all the people out there, msimboje tu serikali tu kwamba tu kusaidia.
Yes.
Remember that mama alikuwa anasema tu saidia serikali, saidia serikali. Yes. I want to play and say now, uh-huh. serikali will not be able to do everything for you.
Yeah.
But I mean, kama MCA, kama kiongozi, I will never do everything for that every person from Kipchoge or what.
Yes.
But what I can do for the community is that I will always try to do what is within my powers to do.
Yes.
Lakini kama unafanya hasuli yako, fanya na haki yako, omba Mungu wako, na utafanikiwa.
Amen.
I always try to save something. You know, this pandemic now, yes. Kufunza kitu moja pia. If you come in mtu ambao unafanya kazi, unakula yote. Right now, unakula nini saa hizi?
True.
So, every person.
Kula ngumu saa.
Kula kidogo, weka kidogo.
Weka kidogo.
That's my parting shot.
All right. Ah, asante sana mheshimiwa. Thank you for, I know it was on a short notice, but like you've always done, you've always come through whenever we need you. And even, you know, I'm a musician, I'm an artist. And
yes.
We've done a couple of events, Jawasani, China Sana, which is also coming up, I think, next week, and a couple of other events. And in all those events, mkono wako ulifika, tusaidia kama wasani, we've been able to, you know, to advance our course through your support. So tunashukuru sana. We really appreciate. So mheshimiwa, nikuulize, ni nini, when ukitoka kwa nyumba, what is that one thing that you cannot leave the house without?
What I cannot leave to?
You cannot leave the house without.
The one that I do or what I do before I leave
anything
the house?
Anything that you own, ukitoka tu kwa nyumba, ni nini was, tuseme umeifika tao, and you have to go back to the house to go and pick it. Ni nini yo? What is that one thing?
Well, that should be actually my diary.
Your diary?
Yes, my little diary.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ah, see, I thought diary could pass.
No, I also have, I still believe in
manual. Physical one, eh?
I still have the physical one.
Okay.
Yeah, because I know phone sometimes, so I have my small diary.
Yeah.
It has my own to-do list for the day.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, on average, mheshimiwa, I do a lot of work on mheshimiwa, and I'm like, hey, maybe you want to see your kienda kuoga na oga na, you know, on average, how long do you take?
Shower.
Kienda kushawa.
So you mean a boy, but so I don't talk about that. I think on average in 5 to 10 minutes.
5 to 10 minutes. Now we're going to shoot.
Yeah, I'm done. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. I have to sip my tea first. When if I'm in English Premier League, yeah? Which football team do you support?
I support Chelsea.
Anyway, Chelsea. Yeah. Akimu litandikwa juzi.
I know.
What?
But yesterday to chapa bottle.
We prepare
for this Champions League. Tukasahau kulikuwa na mechi nyumbani, tukachapa 5-2.
Mulitandikwa mheshimiwa.
But it's okay.
Na yeah. Kenya, which is your team in Kenya?
I support the, of course, our local zoo. I thank God because even all the nyimbo yako na ukaeka Zumbaya.
So talanta za ghetto tikitaka sombrero
ulikeo basi. Eh, hiyo basi.
So Kericho anthem song. Go and watch Kericho anthem song, guys.
Yes. Zoo is my team.
Asante sana mheshimiwa. I think from us it's a wrap. Tumalize. Tumeshukuru sana. I know, guys, leave comments. You know, those of us watching live on YouTube, on Facebook, this clip will be available. If video is available in all social media platforms. But remember, this is Urban Kale TV, and I'm your host, Zion San. And I'd like to give a shout out to my team, you know, the crew. Kuna crew mzima wamesimama hapo manze na my headphones, na my gadgets, nini. You know, big up H2 Videos, Hillary. Big up Hank. Big up Steve Nganga. Big up Jaira. You know, a whole squad up and down manze wana ensure that kazi inafanyika vizuri. Alright, thank you so much. Remember, we've been coming to you from Kipchimat supermarket, but ndani ya Kipchimat restaurant, where you can get all your sumptuous meals. Ukitaka manze, unajua sasa kuna COVID, tuliambiwa kuna hizi dawa tunaweza kunywa, inasaidia. So kuna dawa moja safi sana ndani ya Kipchimat. Unatandika hivi kama inapotea, inaenda mahali mtoka.
Yeah.
And of course, food, meals, ukitaka ram chops, pork chops, kuku, samaki, all types of meals, manzi. You make your way to Kipchimat restaurant, and all these are at affordable, pocket-friendly rates. So from my end, Zion San, nimeshukuru sana. Thank you guys for watching. Remember to subscribe, remember to leave a comment. And Mheshimiwa, watu wanaweza kupata wapi? You can follow you online.
Oh, yes, of course. You can also follow me online. My Facebook page is Eric Bett, People's Watchman.
Mm-hmm.
That's my Facebook page.
Yes.
At Twitter is at Erico Bett.
Oh, okay.
And also I'm on
TikTok.
TikTok? Eh. Not yet, but I'm not in there.
Lazima uge TikTok.
So lazima tunachanua hapo kidogo. TikTok, katengeneza hiyo.
Sawa.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Until next time, keep it here, keep it locked, subscribe. May God bless you. Sante sana.